name is Adam Sutcliffe. When my grandfather was born, he was diagnosed with a spinal abnormality called Spina Bifida. And at age 4, he was told he was going to die. He's 60 now, and I'm going to talk to him about his life and his struggles. This is David Sutcliffe. He is the son of Philip and Lily Sutcliffe, and when he was born, he was diagnosed with meningocele. He was told he wasn't going to live past 4 years old. But despite this, he has gone on to get married, become the doting father of a beautiful girl, and the loving grandfather of 4 grandchildren. Have you always been in a wheelchair?
No, I was walking normally really till I was 11, and then I got a tumour on the back. Luckily it was benign, but I went down to London for an operation on my spine. And what happened was, it was long time before bike surgery and things like that, and to get rid of the tumour, it damaged the nerves to the legs, and that was it then. So I walked with calipers after that, and then started work, and it was too hard getting around on calipers, so I moved into a wheelchair. I've been in a wheelchair about 20 odd years now, 25 years, something like that.
What surgery have you had?
When I was 3 weeks old was the first operation I had. And then I had one when I was 21 to have the hamstrings rejoined in the back of my legs. And then I had 13 operations up at Castle Hill Hospital for fusions on the ankles to keep the ankles up straight.
What jobs were available for you?
When I was in work, not a lot. To be quite honest, it hasn't got much better now. There's still a lot of prejudice out there against disabled people, especially in the workplace. Employers think you're going to be sick half the time, and you know, that's how special things done for you. And you don't really, as long as you can get into the building.
How has spina bifida affected your everyday life?
It doesn't affect. I've got used to it. You know, it doesn't worry me. I manage to get around fairly well. Not so easy these days. I'm getting older, obviously, and you know, things are more of an effort. I mean, I can't get onto a bus. Yeah. I drive my own car. I've driven my own car for years now. One good thing that does help me. I've got my car on the motability scheme. Don't let it worry me. I mean, we've been married 41 years this year. Got Julie, your mum. Got the grandchildren. I don't think I've failed in my life. I've done as much as... The only difference is I push, other people walk.
Is enough being done in the general public to raise awareness about spina bifida?
It's surprising how many people don't even know what it is. I mean, the word spina for a start is spine. But you know, somebody says, what's the matter with you? You tell us. To be honest, I'd just say I had an accident. Because it's quicker than going to all the details. Because they don't understand it anyway.
What is spina bifida?
Spina bifida.
Spina bifida.
I have no idea.
No idea.
I have no idea what it is.
I don't know.
There's something wrong with the spine.
Spina bifida. It's an illness that affects the muscles.
It isn't really my thing.
I don't think I can tell you what it is. Sorry.
To my knowledge, it's a spinal cord disease.
Where did you meet David?
I met him at the Blind Institute where I worked. I thought he was quite nice. He used to sing to me, "I'll be yours in apple blossom time."
I never.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Did.
Was your relationship frowned upon?
Well, yes, I would think it was by a lot of people. And they're tutted and that, but we're still here after 40 years together, so we've proved them wrong.
Is it hard to care for someone with spina bifida?
Well, yes, but you don't bother about that. You just do it day by day. It is awkward, though, sometimes, like cleaning gutters around the house. There's lots of jobs around the house that if someone's got spina bifida, they can't do.
Making this documentary has been a strange experience for me. I've learnt a lot about spina bifida and a lot about my grandma and granddad, and how, despite this condition, they have not let it hinder them and they're living happily married lives.